Technical difficulties. We are back here in the third quarter. 2:10 left to go in this third quarter. St. Joe's down by four to Sayreville, 33-29.
St. Joe's has made a nice comeback here.
Yeah, but every time they seem to be like they got it within 1 point, Sayreville went on a tear. So it's just Sayreville. Travel again on Mikey Grana. So many travels called against St. Joe's today. They can't have these, Aiden, if they want to come back in this game.
They've done a nice job in the second half of defending. But again, Jocelyn Floyd, MIA, he's been kind of not a force, but he's been active on both sides of the ball, affecting some plays.
Towns over
here
to Jocelyn Floyd.
Are in him.
Yeah, so travel on O'Leary.
That's a questionable call there.
Hey, I like it. I'll take it.
Even though I'm from St. Joe's.
I'll take it. I'll take the call.
Biased. We are biased.
Yeah. They're chanting Marcus Towns right now against Xavier.
Is that him right down there? I think he's here.
I think Marcus is here. Interesting to see what color he's wearing. Is he wearing?
I think he's wearing an NBA shirt.
Okay, is he rooting for his brother or his school? Walker gets the jumper to fall.
Walker.
Malachi Walker.
Showing off his touch with a couple jump shots here.
Yeah, absolutely. He's usually a guy who only scores in the post, but Walker's showing it off right now. O'Leary against West. O'Leary, nice defense. Nice play by Martini. Get it off to West. West driving in. Layup. No good. Rebounded by Justine Floyd. No foul call. Now
Mikey
we got
Gronda had
three
not
on, a four
three.
On three right now. O'Leary.
Nice
inside.
Find. That was a great pass, and way to be patient there by Ryan O'Leary to find the open man.
Ope Ololoco scoring there. Gronda, 40 seconds left to go in the third. Greaves. Inside, layup is good for the freshman, Mitchie Greaves. St. Joe's down by two to Sayreville. Outside for Montes for three. No good. Rebounded by Ope Oloco. O'Leary for three. College range. No good. Rebounded by Greaves. Here comes West. Inside. Up and under. Layup and one.
No foul.
I thought I heard a whistle. Oh. Anyways, tie game now. 5 seconds left to go in third. Blocked by Walker, but they're going to say foul. Oh, boy.
Momentum. Uncle Momentum switching sides here.
Yeah, but I thought Walker got a clean block. I think he hit Towns.
I think it was on the contact.
I think Towns.
I believe that's Marcus Towns right there in the yellow hat.
Absolutely. So for Brian O'Reilly, the star football player, who asked, Latrell West has 11 points right now. St. Joe's tied with Sayreville, 35-35, with 5 seconds left to go in this third quarter. Another low-scoring game, Aiden.
Yes, but it's tight. We could be heading into how many no overtimes?
Oh, I hope so. I want to be here until 2 a.m. if we can.
Towns. Might have some restrictions.
I know Mr. Herring's got a baby at home, but, you know, us over here, we don't have that kind of
responsibility.
We don't have that kind of responsibility, so we're allowed to be out all night if we want to. I'm sure Mrs. Herring probably won't like that, though. Towns makes the first one. 1 point lead for Sayreville, 36-35. Second free throw up. Good. Sayreville takes a 2 point lead. 5 seconds left to go in the quarter. West,
still
bring it
time.
Up. West, bring it up. Up and under layup. It's good at the buzzer. Latrell West finding some life. West now has 13 points. Tie game. Heading into the fourth quarter.
Nice job by Latrell West, recognizing how much time was left. Enough time to go right down the court and get an easy bucket.
And I'm going to have Louis DeAngelis come on for the final quarter. Maybe not the final quarter, and maybe we'll get you on for the overtime period if this hangs on. Sayreville has now tied with St. Joe's. What did I tell you guys at halftime? St. Joe's is a second-half team. They've come back all season. Almost every game, it seems like, Lewis. They've been down at halftime, and then they stormed back to tie the game, and they've done so right now.
Latrell West has really had a good third quarter. I believe he had
2 points at halftime. Now he has what?
He has 13, so he had 11,
he had 11 points.
Points
in that third quarter. Huge third quarter. That's more than a point per minute for Latrell West. As we're getting ready for the fourth quarter of this GMC championship game between St. Joe's Falcons and the Sayreville Bombers. And to answer our trivia question, the last time St. Joe's was not in the GMC final, today's seniors were only in the second grade. They've made it to every GMC final since 2007.
I think we're in for a very good fourth quarter here.
I hope so. Xavier Towns, former St. Joseph Falcon, inside to Floyd. Floyd, spin move, no good. Rebound by Walker. Here comes Granda now.
Floyd has been a non-factor on the offensive end today.
I don't know how many. I think he still has 0 points,
I think,
right?
He has 2 points.
2 points, but still, that's not a lot considering what he's been scoring this season. As right now, yeah, he's averaging 9.1 points per game. West, out of bounds. St. Joe's ball. Nice block there from Elijah Clark. As 7:30 left to go in this fourth quarter, St. Joe's and Sayreville tied at 37. Martini outside of Walker, whose jump shot has been falling. Foul on Elijah Clark. Got a little handsy with Latrell West there.
It's going to be very physical in this last quarter, especially the tension between Xavier Towns, Latrell West.
Absolutely. Looks like they're putting Elijah Clark on him right now. Xavier's guarding Richie Greaves, who he was not a teammate with since Greaves is only a freshman. Martini, another freshman inside. Layup is good. And the foul, no basket travel. Really questionable call.
I believe because he bumped him, that's why Martini might have moved his feet a bit. But
that's why it hurts. 7:20 left to go. Still tie game, 37-37. Xavier Towns, the former Falcon with St. Joe's legend Marcus Towns in attendance. Can he be the hero for Sayreville? Trying to win their first GMC championship in 17 years. Floyd misses the basket, misses the dunk, but he gets fouled. He's going on the line.
I think Coach Turco has had enough with these calls.
I
mean, that one I think was a foul, but.
No, the refs are doing a pretty good job here. They're getting a lot of travel. Yeah, that's a foul.
Yeah.
That's definitely a foul, but on Martini. Floyd's free throw up. Good. Just seen Floyd averaging 9.1 points per game. He's made 35 free throws this season. He made 36 right there. Second free throw up. And no good. Rebounded by Ololoco. Sayreville ball. Floyd inside. Travel.
I could have really either went with the charge there or travel. I think the ref got it right.
Wow. Another travel. This has been very travel happy. You never see a lot of travel calls in basketball. That's a good call there. Granda, 7 minutes left. St. Joe's down by one. Who will be the hero tonight?
I don't know, but I would get it to Latrell West.
Absolutely. The way he's been doing that third quarter. Walker inside to Granda. Outside to West. West guarded by Elijah Clark, former football player. Inside West. Fouled and no good, but he's going on the line.
Latrell West stared down Elijah Clark there after he got the foul.
Yeah, Xavier Towns stared down Latrell West after he blocked him.
Looks like it's back and forth here.
Floyd almost had a dunk, on Latrell West. And guess who's coming back in, unfortunately, for St. Joe's? Ryan O'Leary, the star player, all GMC player, Ryan O'Leary. West free throw up and good, ties the game.
I don't think we saw O'Leary much in the third quarter. I guess he was resting. I don't know.
That's what I'm scared of, because now he's got 6:30 left to go, and he's got a fresh Ryan O'Leary. Doesn't spell good news for St. Joe's. Second free throw for West to take the lead is good. Latrell West coming alive. What does he have, 15 points right now? 15 points for Latrell West. Towns guarded by Granda, former teammates for 3 years going at it. Stolen by Granda, out of bounds. St. Joe's ball.
I think it hit Towns on the wrist after Granda stole it out of his hand.
Granda clapping in the face of Towns right there. You gotta love it from former teammates.
Yep,
it did. Good call. The referees were on their game tonight.
I think that's St. Joe's first lead of the game.
Yeah, it's a good step. Exactly. I think that is the first lead of the game for St. Joe's. Walker gives it to Granda. Granda open, gets inside, blocked by Floyd, he gets fouled, he is going to the line. Senior Mikey Granda making it to his fourth GMC final.
He
gets
really,
to the bucket.
He's really tough though. I mean, Questian Floyd, 6'8". I don't know if that was a foul, but.
That is a clean block.
Granda went flying there. I think it's all right.
You know what? You got an 11-inch height difference. I would probably go flying too. First free throw for Granda is good. St. Joe's 2-point lead over Sayreville now. 6:06 left to go in this game. Granda. Been on the varsity team all 4 years. He was on that team with Xavier Towns and his brother Marcus Towns when they won the TOC final. Second free throw is good. St. Joe's 3-point lead now. Almost thrown away. O'Leary gets back to Xavier Towns. Inside, Towns to Floyd. Gets the bucket. Just seem Floyd getting it done. St. Joe's 1-point lead, 5:50 left to go in this game. Here comes Latrell West. Timeout, St. Joe's.
This is getting very physical.
Wow. Wow, Lewis. This is You know, St. Joe's is down by 11. I thought, oh my goodness, this could be a blowout. But St. Joe's is stormed back, led by Latrell West. 2 points first half, 13 in the second half. 15 overall for Latrell West, who is putting on a show in the second half.
And I said earlier, who's going to step up for St. Joe's? And Latrell West has, with 13 points in the second half so far. Or after the first quarter.
Averaging more than a point per minute in the second half is Latrell West. So we got both fan sections trying to outdo each other right now.
I think one of those fans just ruined what both fan sections.
I think they're very excited for this end of this game, Lewis. I think that's what it shows right there on the scoreboard.
Yeah.
You know, if I wasn't broadcasting right now, I'd be jumping up and down right now. This is an amazing game right now. St. Joe's trying to win their seventh GMC championship in the last 8 years. Sayreville trying to win their first GMC championship since 2000. 17 years since Sayreville's last in the GMC final. St. Joe's has made it to 10th straight. Granda gives to Greaves. Outside of Latrell West. GMC champion last year with St. Joe's when they beat South Brunswick. Can he do it again? Inside West. Layup, no good. Rebound by Martini. Inside to West. West to Floyd. Good play by Malachi Walker. Oh, I thought Richie Greaves was going to have the save of the year right there. We're going to say out of bounds, terrible ball.
Man, this is getting intense.
This is getting really intense. 5:13 left to go. St. Joe's up by one. 41-40 against Sayreville for the GMC championship game. Doesn't get anything better than this, Lewis. O'Leary, guarded by freshman Richie Greaves. Gives it out to Jaseem Floyd, guarded by another freshman, Zach Martini. O'Leary, star player for Sayreville. Can he come up big here? Dangerous pass.
Yep, push on Floyd there.
Push on Jaseem Floyd.
I think Richie Greaves was trying to go for the steal, and Floyd pushed him out of the way.
Jaseem Floyd's fourth foul. If he gets one more foul, he's out of the game, Lewis.
That's huge. If I was the Sayreville coach, John Wojcik, I would take him out.
I'll take him out, exactly. I would take him out now, put him in for the last 2 minutes. Walker.
He has an open three. He's not going to take it.
No, he's not a good three-point shooter at all. I'm pretty sure Turco would go out there and hit him if he took a three right there. Greaves. Nice little step back. Greaves to Walker. Another jumper from Walker. Two-pointer, no good. Rebound by Towns. Xavier Towns outside to Clark for three, no good. Rebound by Martini. Losing the ball, kickball violation. St. Joe's ball.
I don't think there's been a point in about a minute, but this is intense.
This is intense. Coach Wojcik is very familiar. Very familiar right now. With Coach Turco. Wojcik played for that 2000 Sayreville team that won the GMC Championship. They played against Carteret, who was coached by Coach Dave Turco, now coach of St. Joe's. Greaves Mid-range jumper, no good. Rebounded by Jacine Floyd. Floyd coming up. Oh, could have been another push there. Inside, Clark layup. Sayreville takes a 2-1-point lead now. 4:01 left to go in this game. St. Joe's down by one to Sayreville. Could have been a push on Jacine Floyd. He could have been fouled out there. Nice pass to find Elijah Clark, his football teammate as well as his basketball teammate. Sayreville's up by one. Tyrese Ford still on the bench right now, just stretching out that leg. Looks like a good camera angle from Aiden. He's got his shoe off right now. It's still that ankle. It looks bad. That ankle is giving him problems right now. He's got his right shoe off. Looks like that right ankle really giving Tyrese Ford problems. So that means that the five we see right now are most likely the five we're going to see for the rest of the game, Lewis.
Yeah, I honestly think that Dave Turco won't sub in any other guys other than Tyrese Ford right now.
You know what? I misspoke there. Chris the trainer, you know, I saw him hit a few threes earlier in the gym. We were shooting around. Who knows? Be able to put Chris the trainer out there, see if he can get some magic in him. Here comes St. Joe's now. 4:01 left to go in this GMC championship game. St. Joe's Falcon Flock, nervously excited, I would say. Nervously confident, looks like. Latrell West gives it to Mikey Granda. 4 minutes left in this GMC championship. Former teammates going at it. Towns against Granda. They played on the same team for 3 years. Very good friends. No foul. West gets the ball. Granda comes up gingerly. That's big because Tyrese Ford's already hurt. Who's going to come in if Granda can't come out?
I don't know. That's the question. That's why I think he's going to keep this five.
Yeah. West up-handed layup. Acrobatic layup for Latrell West. Now has 17 points. Towns looks like he's calling ISO right now. Going to give it off to Opeola Loco. Almost stole my West. He's averaging 2.7 steals per game. That's most on the team. O'Leary, star player. Trying to find other star player. Can't get it because Mike Grando, a star player in his own right, gets it. West dribbles inside. Layup, no good, no foul. Elijah Clark now. Towns, jumper, travel, no good. Towns, angry.
That was close. I think the ref got it right, though.
I thought it got it. Towns got to be careful here. He might get a technical foul. 3 minutes left. 180 seconds is all that separates St. Joe's or Sayreville from a GMC championship. St. Joe's 1-point lead, 43-42, 2:50 left to go. West for three, deep three, no good, not a great shot. Off of Zach Martini, Sayreville ball. Towns looks exhausted. 2:44 left, Lewis. Who's Sayreville going to here?
I don't know. I mean, Floyd has been a non-factor so far. I mean, I think Towns.
Yeah, you know, if I was watching, I would say, you know what, go beat your former team, get the bucket, get that sweet victory. I give it to Xavier Towns. He's been hot tonight. He's got, I believe, 13 points. Floyd inside of Martini. Little spin move, little jumper for the big man. No good. Off of Richie Greaves. Stays Sayreville ball.
Zach Martini's doing a good job keeping up with Christine Floyd. I mean, Martini's not nearly as fast as him, but.
No, how about, Jacine Floyd, all GMC player. Not doing that well right now against Malachi Walker and Zach Martini. Sayreville's the only team in the GMC to have two all GMC players. It's Ryan O'Leary and Jacine Floyd. Acrobatic layup for Towns, no good. St. Joe's ball off of Xavier Towns.
Oh boy, we're coming down
here
for
we
a
go.
Game here.
Here we go, Lewis. Big possession here for St. Joe's, trying to make it a 3-point game or even a 4-point game if they get a good shot. St. Joe's now bring it up. Mikey Grana, crossover on Xavier Towns. Timeout. I don't know why they were called timeout there. It looked like St. Joe's had numbers.
They had numbers.
They had numbers, exactly.
And I think Malachi had an open jump shot. But
yeah, maybe that's why they called a timeout there. Because I don't know if I was 2:06 left to go. I don't know if I would have put my offense in the jump shot of Malachi Walker. But he's an amazing post player. Also a fantastic defender. Averaging 4.8 blocks per game. That is the most in the state. Malachi Walker, all division. Also named to our good buddy James Corrigan's all-GMC tournament team. along with Latrell West and Xavier Towns and Ryan O'Leary and Justine Floyd. 2:06 left, 126 seconds left in this GMC Championship. St. Joe's 1-point lead over Sayreville. Who's going to come up big in the final 2:06?
I don't know. It's going to be interesting. I think it's going to be between Towns
and West. You got to be. Got to be. Don't rule out Granda, though. Granda's made it to 4 straight GMC finals at St. Joe's. He's won 2. Of course, they lost to Colonia 2 years ago in the RAC. The last time St. Joe's played in the RAC, they lost to Colonia in the GMC final. That was the last time St. Joe's lost in the GMC tournament back in 2015. They won the GMC championship last year against South Brunswick, trying to make it 2-for-2 here. Walker, 1:50 left. St. Joe's 1-point lead. They're going to try to waste a clock down, maybe. West loses it. Walker, Granda. Granda, they're going to waste a clock down. I love it, Coach Turco
very
here.
Smart.
100 seconds left to go in this GMC championship. Timeout, Coach Turco. St. Joe's now has 2 timeouts left to go in this game. Sayreville has 3.
Coach Turco being very smart right now, taking time off the clock, even though it's a 1-point lead. He can trust his team right now. Get a bucket late, unless they start fouling, which I don't think would happen because it's only a 1-possession game.
St. Joe's has, I misspoke, St. Joe's has 1 timeout left. Sayreville has 3. Toby Ololoco is over there. And interesting to see if he's rooting for St. Joe's, because his cousin, Ope Ololoco, is on the Sayreville team, and Ope Ololoco has 4 points tonight for Sayreville. So another one, Marcus Towns, like we always said, St. Joe's legend, was one of the best players on that team when they won the Tournament of Champions championship with Carl Anthony Towns, Wade Baldwin, Brian Tyree, all Division I players. Marcus Towns is a Division I player as well. Loyola Chicago. His younger brother, Xavier Towns, came to St. Joe's for 3 years, was on the varsity team for 3 years, and then decided he wanted to go to Sayreville, where he is now and where he is against St. Joe's in the GMC Championship in a Kevin Durant versus Oklahoma City type game.
Very good comparison there, Max.
And then Latrell West, I would say, is a little bit like Westbrook. Hopefully he gets an amazing dunk over here.
Yeah.
Walker, 1:30 left. St. Joe's 1-point lead. Who's going to be the hero? Greaves to Walker. To Greaves. 1:20 left. 80 seconds is all that separates St. Joe's from their 7th GMC championship in the last 8 years. Granda, guarded by Towns. Loses the ball. Gets it back. Timeout. St. Joe's.
That's their last timeout.
Wow.
I don't know if I would use it now.
How about the hustle play from Mikey Granda to jump on top of that ball? It looked like it would have been stolen by Towns, and O'Leary is about to get it. Watch this right here. Loses the ball. O'Leary almost got it, but Mikey Granda, one of the best hustle players I've ever seen at St. Joe's, gets the ball from O'Leary. No jump ball as O'Leary wanted it. St. Joe's keeps possession, but they do use their final timeout, Lewis, which could be huge. 68 seconds left to go in this GMC final. This is St. Joe's 10th straight GMC final. This is Sayreville's first GMC final since 2000. It's been 17 years since Sayreville last won a GMC championship and even made it to a GMC championship. They've made it to the finals 4 times, only won it once back in 2000 when Coach Wozchik was a star player. Now he coaches Sayreville, so he's trying to get a ring as a player and coach for Sayreville.
Thing to know, I don't think Sayreville's had the ball in a couple of minutes, because St. Joe's, since at least 2 minutes left, has held the ball.
Well, in that Old Bridge game, I remember when they won tip-off at Old Bridge, and that overtime, they literally held the ball for 4 minutes, because there's no shot clock in high school. They held it and took a last shot. So tip, jump ball, and they got it back. West inside, layup is good, Latrell West, 3-point lead for St. Joe's. 1 minute left, Towns. Guarded by Granda. Gives it to Jason DeMild, star football quarterback. Stolen kickball.
Ooh. All right. getting very, very chippy here.
54 seconds left to go in this GMC final. St. Joe's 3-point lead off the layup from the Trail West. West now has 19 points tonight. Towns, O'Leary, three! No good, rebound by Walker. Gives it to Granda. 48 seconds left to go. Granda to West. Foul.
That's exactly who you want on the free throw line. I don't think it's a double bonus. I don't think it's in the bonus yet.
No, you're right.
I would give it to Granda.
In fact, I don't even think it's shooting fouls yet. It's only 16 fouls. They've got to foul again before St. Joe's goes to the line.
That takes some time off the clock.
So now, Lewis, this is what I would do. No matter what, do not give it to Malachi Walker or Zach Martini, because then they will have to shoot free throws. Just try to get it as much as you can to Latrell West, who's being guarded by former teammate Xavier Towns. Greaves inbounding it, guarded by O'Leary. O'Leary's got like a 5-inch height difference on him, but he gets it into Walker. Foul, and Walker is going to the line.
Hey, at least he got it in. They have no timeouts. It's better than giving the ball
exactly,
to Sayreville.
Exactly. So you know what? I'd rather have Malachi Walker at the line. He's still not a bad free throw shooter, Lewis. He's coming into the game. I believe he's made 23 free throws this year, averaging 6.8 points per game. He's got six right now. Walker, third year on varsity. This is his second GMC championship game. Actually, I'm sorry, his third straight year in the GMC championship game. He's a two-time GMC champ. Can he come up big and win his third GMC championship? First free throw up. Good, Malachi Walker coming up big for St. Joe's. Timeout Sayreville. Sayreville now has two timeouts left to go in this game. 44.4 seconds left to go in this game. St. Joe's 4-point lead over Sayreville as they were down by 11 at one point, and they storm back in that second half and now have a 4-point lead.
If Malachi Walker makes this shot, it's going to be tough for Sayreville to come back, because they got to come down, score a layup or a three, and then they got to get the ball back after they foul. So it's going to be tough. St. Joe's is very good in these situations.
Absolutely. Coming out of the timeout now, 44.4 seconds left to go. St. Joe's can taste that GMC championship, trying to win their seventh GMC championship in the last 8 years. Also trying to win their 10th GMC championship overall. Latrell West getting the crowd pumped up.
This is a big free throw here.
This is a huge free throw. Second free throw for senior Malachi Walker, all division player, all GMC tournament player. Up and good, Malachi Walker coming up huge for St. Joe's. Towns bring it up fast. Out of bounds, Sayreville ball.
This has been a great game, but honestly, it's not that high of a scoring game. I mean, usually high school
defense.
You get up to 60, 70.
Exactly, yeah.
It's only 44.
Floyd. St. Joe's up by 5, 47-42, 38 seconds left. You got to get a bucket now. Foul by West. That's only the 15th foul on St. Joe's, so it will not go to the line yet.
And I think that's what Turco wants, because it takes I guess, more time, but then it puts them in the line so they can't get a chance to hit a three.
DeMild getting it in to Towns. 30 seconds left. Another foul by Mikey Granda. I like the strategy from Turco here. It wastes clock. But now, if you foul Sayreville again, now they will shoot free throws if you foul him again. 33.4 seconds left to Mild. The star quarterback throwing it in. Outside to Ryan O'Leary. O'Leary to Floyd. Floyd, layup is good. 2-point game. 25.5 seconds left to go in this game. St. Joe's, has a 3-point lead. I forgot that Malachi Walker made it. Two free throws. So St. Joe's 3-point lead now with 25.5 seconds left to go in this GMC final. Wow, okay, Lewis. St. Joe's, this is their 23rd GMC final that they've made it to. They're trying to win their 10th GMC championship. They've made it to 10 straight GMC finals. The last time they didn't make it to the GMC finals, Latrell West, Malachi Walker, and Mikey Granda were all in the second grade. Trying to go for their seventh GMC championship in the last 8 years. The only one in the last 8 years they haven't won was against Colonia 2 years ago. So since they didn't make it to the GMC championship in 2007, they've won every GMC championship since then, besides 2015, when they lost to Colonia 54-38. This is the first time in 5 years that St. Joe's is playing Sayreville. Inbound, huge inbound here. They've got to get it in cleanly. Latrell West throwing it in. Gives it to Martini. Back to West. Foul, and Martini's going on the line.
Martini has a good shot, so I'm not surprised if he'll make two here. But
and again, all he really needs to do, Lewis, I know making two will be great, but if he makes one, that's still big because it's a two-possession game then.
Definitely.
So, of course, we want the two free throws to make it a five-point game, but even if he only makes one, that's still a two-possession game with 24.2 seconds left. Elijah Clark and Ope Oloco check out. Jason DeMild and number three, Henderson Wates comes in.
Now it's all the starters back in.
Martini with Tyree Ford still nursing an ankle injury. He's been out almost the entire game. Up, no good. Sayreville's got a chance to tie it now. Xavier Towns bringing it up.
Lots of screen.
Most threes on the team. Losing the ball. Floyd. Outside. DeMild. Three. No good. Rebounded. DeMild. Three. No good. Rebounded. St. Joe's ball. 6 seconds left.
Now you got a foul. There's no excuse. Now you got a. That's not the shot, I think.
Yeah, why would DeMild, that second three was not a good shot. Look at this three. The first one was okay. But watch the second one. He's got two guys on him. Takes him a crazy three. Completely misses it. And now with 6 seconds left, St. Joe's got to inbound it. Gives it to Grana. Can he dribble it out? Gets fouled. Going on the line. 4.4 seconds left to go. St. Joe's basically one free throw away from icing it. And no one better than Mikey Gronda, his fourth year on the varsity team, his first year when he's a freshman. They won the GMC championship. They won the Tournament of Champions championship with Carl Anthony Towns, Wade Baldwin, and Marcus Towns, and Xavier Towns, who is now playing for Sayreville. Looks like Sayreville's going to take a timeout right after this free throw. Or right after. It's still 1-1, so Mikey Gronda misses it. They still have a shot. He makes it. St. Joe's 4-point lead.
I think that iced it right there.
Second free throw for Gronda, the senior captain. Up. Good. 5-point lead for St. Joe's. Timeout, Sayreville. Timeout, Sayreville. 4.4 seconds left in this game. St. Joe's 4 seconds away from winning their seventh GMC championship in the last 8 years. And to answer our earlier question, Toby Oloco looks pretty happy right now, even though his cousin plays for Sayreville, Ole Oloco. But, Lewis, I've seen crazier things happen. 5-point lead. Turco's getting pumped. Look at Turco jumping up and down in the huddle. That is awesome. That is, yeah, exactly. That is the most exercise looks like Turco got in a long time. I love it. Coach Turco jumping up and down.
I think it's because there's all these young kids, like, you know.
And they came back. They came back, Lewis. You know, someone told me St. Joe's is not going to win this game because they're inexperienced. They came back. They're down by 11. They came back. They fought back. And they're about to win their seventh GMC championship in 8 years. DeMile, quarterback style throw, suits him. Out of bounds, St. Joe's ball.
It's a lot different throwing a basketball than a football, that's for sure. Yeah.
DeMile had 2 3-pointers to try to tie the game. He couldn't do it. St. Joe's about to win another GMC championship, their seventh last 8 years.
That situation, you got to give the ball to Towns or O'Leary.
Exactly.
I don't know why. I don't know what he was thinking.
Yeah, I mean, I knew he wanted it tight. I don't think he thought that was that much time. But, yeah, O'Leary has made 36 three-pointers on the team on the year. Towns is not as good of a three-point shooter. DeMille's made 9 three-pointers on the year. He tried to make it his 10th, but he couldn't get it there. Foul. Grana's going to the line. Grana says, why would you foul me? Why can't you just take it? Henderson Montes not giving up yet, though. Granda, 3.8 seconds left. Once again, going on the line. Now he can really ice it. First free throw up for Granda. No good. That was 10 feet foul. So, yeah, there's 2 shots, yeah. Floyd had the right idea, though. Second free throw for Granda, up. And it is good. 6-point lead for St. Joe's, 3.8 seconds left. Floyd. Three-pointer, no good. And that ends it. For the seventh time in the last 8 years, the St. Joseph Falcons are GMC champions. And for the 10th time overall, St. Joe's is GMC champions. Coming back from down 11 to Sayreville. They've won 50-44. Coach Turco looks the happiest I've ever seen him.
And you know one thing, though. If I was Tari Ford, I would really want to get back in that game. But now you got to think to the States. I mean, if he goes back in that game, gets hurt,
see that?
And then he's out for the rest of the game, like the rest of the year, but he could have iced it and then gotten better.
Yeah, I like the little cold shoulder there from Xavier Towns. Kind of a little hand slap, not really talking to anyone. Xavier Towns put on a show tonight, though. Against his former team, he had 13 points. O'Leary only had 11. And for St. Joe's, Granda had 13, West 19, Ford had 8, even though he only played a little bit. Granda had, like we said, 8, Greaves had 5, Walker came up big, he had 8, and Martini had 2. St. Joe's wins their 10th GMC championship, their 7th in the last 8 years, as they win 50-44. Over Sayreville. We want to thank you guys so much for listening to our broadcast. From Max Chadwick, Louis DeAngelis, Aiden Drury, Mr. Herring, Max Shiner. We want to thank you guys all for tuning in. And guys, the season is not over yet for either Sayreville or St. Joe's. St. Joe's next plays on Thursday against either number 7 Union Catholic or number 10 Bishop Barr. As you thought this game was a great game, wait until the state tournament gets going. St. Joe's number 2 seed in the state tournament. Sayreville is the number 5 seed in the state tournament. They will be playing against number 12, Hightstown. So both seasons are not over for these two teams. We want to congratulate Sayreville on a great season. Congratulate our good buddy Xavier Towns on a great season as well. St. Joe's wins their 7th GMC championship in the last 8 years, 10th overall. And that'll about do it for us. As thank you guys so much for listening. It's been really a lot of fun. It's one of our best ones we've ever done. And that about does it for us. So thank you guys so much for listening. St. Joe's GMC Championships, GMC Champions once again.